One of Jamal's boys was massacred by the serpent, and the other four grabbed Keldon. It took all of Jamal's gang to hold Keldon down, and even then my little brother fought with a strength of 10 men. Everything had happened so fast, I was still in shock, struggling to process it all. Then it all came rushing back on top of me. The screams, the blood, Father Kenneth's mother. My eyes darted to the front of the community center where Miss Lau and her husband were helping her to a pavilion to rest. She looked as pale as a ghost, and as I got closer, I realized her body seemed nearly paralyzed. Kenneth was breathing ragged, crawling away from Keldon as the gang held him back. The demon.
The demon is not of hell. It is far worse, he said, as I came to his side.
I thought about what Naomi had said. The Loa. We have to destroy it, I said, as I looked toward the backpack. The hiding place Keldon had cleverly used throughout our nightmarish journey. Suddenly he screamed and his demonic eyes looked straight at me.
Destroy that Loa, and your brother will never see the light of day again.
Keldon snarled. Except I knew it wasn't my brother speaking anymore. This was an evil worse than I could possibly imagine. Father Ken reached for the crucifix around his neck, his hand barely able to stay up, but it was too late. Keldon let out another guttural shriek, and I watched in horror as Ken's body began to writhe. The wounds where the demon had attacked him were now sizzling with acid. The serpent now had its sights on the pastor. It wrapped its body around Ken, suffocating the life out of him as I watched in abject horror. Damar pulled out his gun, pointed it at the pastor, and let a single bullet finish the job.
Better for him not to suffer, Damar said coldly. The others didn't object. Instead, their focus was on Keldon.
They managed to take him to the storeroom and close the door, leaving only a plexiglass window between us and this abomination. And for a brief second, I thought that Keldon would try to attack again. His eyes shone with a fiery death. But instead, he leaned against the glass and hissed.
Release me, and we can make a bargain for your mother's soul.
I looked towards Mama, seeing how she was just barely holding on.
What have you done to her? I screamed.
All I seek is my freedom, child. This body does not suit my purposes,
the demon answered.
Miss Lau jumped up and moved towards us, her eyes full of panic. He lies! Do not trust this monster, Ashley! What do you mean? I asked. You spoke of the Loa? I once prayed to those false idols. Where is it? She replied.
Do not listen to her,
Keldon shrieked. My hands balled up into fists. I was tired of being manipulated. Jakeem, Kev, can you watch him? I asked.
The two young men nodded, and I followed Miss Lau to the backpack. I heard my little brother scream as I reached inside and took out the Loa. It was not hot, but it burned my hands. Miss Loa's husband and the shop owner's spouse came over as well, all equally intrigued.
This is to never be used without sacrifice. How could you be so foolish? Mr. Lau chided me.
They didn't know, his wife told him. What can we do? I asked. I wanted to be brave, to save both Mama and Keldon.
A demon such as this can't simply be destroyed by sheer force. Willpower and strength must come into play, Miss Lau commented as she examined the idol.
But first, the Loa must be destroyed, Mr. Lau confirmed. The monster that was in my brother's body kept shrieking for me to stop, but I didn't listen. Instead, I grabbed the burning Loa and ran towards the stairs. I could only think of one place to go, the upper windows that overlooked the streets. And as I opened the panel and heard the riots and protests below, I wondered briefly if the demon had awoke because of the violence that was stirring in Los Angeles. I could see the police and the National Guard pushing back, containing the riots, but none of them were here to help me or anyone in our community. I had to do this on my own. I could feel the idol growing hotter as I raised it up, and then smashed it down to the streets below. It felt like a boulder, scattering apart amid the protesters the way the tear gas would. Immediately, I felt like a weight had lifted from my chest, but the battle was only half won. I made it into the church again, checking on Mama and seeing if she was slowly returning to herself. Now all that was left was Keldon, Without the lower to return to, the demon must find a new host. Otherwise, it will be in your brother forever, Miss Lau commented. It said it didn't want to be inside him, so why can't it just leave? I asked. A vessel must offer itself up. Without the Loa, it cannot survive for long. It can puppet others, but in order to be free, it must have a host. This is the way of Bakala Baku, a soul for a soul, Miss Lau said. My hands trembled as I thought of all the destruction the demon could cause if it was allowed to roam free. Even in Keldon's body, it held immense strength, but if I could get it inside me, maybe I could end the nightmare once and for all. Let him go. I can be his vessel, I said bravely. Inwardly, I was scared. I knew to defeat this demon, I would have to give up everything of myself and even my life. But for my family, it would be worth it. Ash, what's gotten into you? Damar asked as he stood in my way. I can't let Keldon suffer anymore. This was my fault from the beginning. I should have trusted in God. Jamal shook his head negatively, preventing me as well. God didn't have nothing to do with this. You made it this far on your own, girl. We all did these past few days. Nobody came to save us. We can save ourselves, Jamal said firmly as he looked towards Miss Lau. You said it needs a willing vessel? How about four? He said. His gang hung on his every word. I was stunned by his words. The demon writhed in the locked room, eager to be able to begin the transfer.
Yes, you will do. They will all do nicely, it hissed.
No, don't do this, I urged him. Was he aware of what would happen? To all of them? Miss Lau, keep her back. We got this, Jamal decided. His other gang members opened the door and Keldon stared eye to eye with the gang leader. I'll do it then, he said. I knew he didn't want to second guess himself. We all watched in complete fascination as the darkness that was in my brother pushed its way out. Like a shadowy version of the snake that we had seen twice now, the spirit zigzagged across the church. Keldon screamed, and the demon made its sound of 100 different wails. It pushed its way straight into Jamal's chest and then towards the others. Their bodies briefly hovered as it was strung up like a puppet. For a moment, the gang lay on the still floor. Then we heard the demonic laughter. It filled the church. They rose in unison.
You fools. The power I now hold to create more chaos, destruction. This city will be brought to ruin by my hands, it shrieked.
It turned towards Damar, Kev, and Jakeem.
Come, servants. Dispose of these meddlers, it screamed.
Above us, the community center seemed to shake. It wasn't an earthquake, though. It was coming from the immense evil in front of us.
I will destroy this city. You vile creatures can't help but to hate. And I will consume, the dark voice said,
growing louder as the building shook and I covered Miss Lau. It looked like we were done for. The shopkeeper's wife knew this was the end of days. Tears began streaming down her cheek as she explained, if the Bakala Baku gets out, the riots will continue. The violence will continue. Chaos will continue. It's gasoline being thrown onto a raging flame. The gang began to move together, all mimicking each other's actions. I thought of all that we had lost trying to save Mama, trying so hard to find help in this broken system. Nothing had saved us, not the police, not the church. And now it looked like even our community would break apart. And then I saw the light of hope in their eyes. Something was changing. These men were fighting the evil that tried to hold them down. The building kept shaking, the air filled with a malevolent force of nature like a storm inside. The demon was fighting with all its strength to keep them under its thumb. The three of them knew what to do. They would stand up for all of us today. They aimed their weapons at Jamal, at each other.
No. No! I command you!
It screamed as loud as it could. It was over in just a few seconds. The blood spattering against the walls as they finished each other off. The storm collapsed instantly. The portions of the church it had torn off fell to the ground. The screams melted into the abyss below. I pulled Keldon from the corpses, got to Mama's side, my entire body trembling and wondering if that ordeal was over.
How did they overcome the demon? I whispered. I could still hear its screams as it sank to the pit of hell. Their will was strong. Your mother... No, your entire family lost their way. But now, thanks to these brave men, our community's strength, you found yourself again, Miss La said, as Mama reached out and touched my hand. Ashley, baby, what happened? She asked gently. I thought of how much we lost and couldn't even find the words to explain to her. Outside, I heard the riots grow even more, even though there was chaos on the outside still. We found peace on the inside, amongst each other. News reports said that Jamal and his gang were involved in a raid on the church during the riots. But I told Mama a different story, one of how four brave young men did everything for us, for the community. This community is strong together, she often would tell me afterwards. We take care of our own and protect those we love. As the great Maxine Waters once said, I don't intend to be excluded or dismissed. We have an awful lot to say. My nightmare ends here, but I still often reflect on those dark days and all that we learned from them. How we had to find faith in each other. We need that kind of faith and hope these days. When you turn on the news and you see what the world is like, violence returning, darkness, that reminds me of how we only have each other to depend on. My hope now is that I can impart that to others, help them see in darkness. There are also those that shine light. Even when the odds are against us, there's hope. Hope that we have each other to lean on. No matter how hard they try to tear us down, we stay as one until the end of time. We are a family. And like I said at the beginning, that can be everything you ever need.
Hey there kids, it's me, Mr. Creepypasta, and I just wanted to tell you thank you so much for watching tonight's video. Or listening to tonight's podcast on the podcast, if you're listening to that there at Spotify or Apple Podcasts or Google Podcasts or wherever you could happen to listen to podcasts. I wanted to remind you guys also that my wife sells loose leaf tea at Etsy.com/shop/ivory-monocle-tea. She has different teas, including Creepypasta teas, and you can get a Mr. Creepypasta tea. If you ask for a dabbing sticker, she also has those. And of course, I wanted to give a big thank you to everyone who checks out patreon.com/MrCreepyPasta and supports the show, keeps the light on, gives me treats for my now two cats, both Hylas and Hercules. Both of them are a handful. And especially a big thank you to Haha Saha, Jordan Alexander Sanchez, Mazakine, Ken Lenda Higuchi, Chompinski, Nico Kao, Tristan Pelton, Stephen Van Huss, Chance Burnett, Diana Kraus, G. Weevil 3, The Red Oak Shield Virus, Hades Nephew, Carter Barenfanger, Dr. Strawberry, Jordan Wayne Deckard, Bradney Lipe, The Government Monitoring System, Anne Charon, Rumble Fox, Acid System, Mike Bullock, Rafael Rodriguez, Dan Sweet, Mad Marshdomp, Prozac and Pancake Appreciation Society, Sean Mills, Brian Arce, Cryptic Nightmares, Shadow Morningstar, Somber Puppet, Brianna Wright, Someone You Love, Said the King 56, Bad Honey, S-Man, Kiri the Sloth, Patrick Schoolmeister, Thomas Burgett, Barbara Maceo, Bobby Carmen, Liam Newman, The Homeless Bird 93, Sky Harbor, Caleb Dougal, Last Blade Song, Eliminator 86, The Ginger Bros, Aaron Stormcrow, and Corey X. Kenshin. A big thank you to all of you guys and everybody down there in the description. I really can't thank you guys enough for supporting the show. Thank you, thank you, thank you. And everybody who listens, sweet dreams.